If you don't sacrifice for what you want becomes a sacrifice.
Welcome friends to this episode of Connecting the Dots, an attempt to bring to spotlight some real life heroes who motivate us and inspire us in achieving our goals. Today we have with us Anukriti. She's a proud CA final student now. She has cleared both her foundation as well as intermediate level in the very first attempt, and I was fortunate enough to mentor her at both the levels. In this conversation, we'll cover up her journey from Durgapur, relatively a small town in West Bengal, to Kolkata, a metropolitan city. How she juggled between her studies and adapting to a new environment. We'll talk about that, right? Because a lot of us come from small towns to big cities to achieve our dreams. So this conversation, I am sure, will definitely inspire you to aspire beyond your comfort zone and get out of your shells. Welcome, Anukriti.
Thank you, sir, for having me here. It's a great pleasure to be here.
Great. So, as they say, that enjoy the journey, not the destination. Right. So, tell us about how easy or difficult it was for you to come from Durgapur to Kolkata and adopt to this environment. We'd like to know about your journey from Durgapur to Kolkata.
Yes, sir. It was not at all easy, as it seems, because coming from a small town, it's not a small, we can say, but compared to Kolkata, it's very small. Durgapur, it is very good for science student because there is an IT and all, but for commerce student, they have to look for opportunities here and there. Yes. So from there, I came to know about this CA course when I was in class 12 from my teachers, and then asked it about from my father. He is not from this background also, so he said the CA is a very good course, you should look for this. So I just went through all of this ICI website and all, and then I thought it okay, this is the one thing I want to do.
Right, so you first did your research, identified your interest and made this decision to pursue CA. Great.
Yes, sir.
So when did you move to Kolkata? After your class 12?
Yes, sir. After completing my class 12, then I searched for classes online because I can't come here only because if I don't have any classes.
Right.
So online I got PrepRite first only. So I thought that I'll do from here, and then I shifted here and then I contacted sir.
Right. So once you moved to Kolkata, right, you started your college, I believe. Then you started your tuitions as well, right? It was a complete new environment. Yes. So can you tell us about your experience as to what are the do's and don'ts when somebody is moving from a different place and trying to adopt in a bigger place?
As I said that Durgapur is not as big as Kolkata.
Right.
So coming here, it was very difficult for me to adapt, first of all, because coming from my comfort zone, basically.
Right.
There in Durgapur, I didn't have much exposure to anything. But here, I have to do everything by my own.
Right. So you searched for a PG,
yes,
and then identified where to study.
Yes,
then
sir.
Again, it's traveling also, because from one place to other place. Right. So was it easy for you?
No, sir, it was not at all easy for you because my father always took me everywhere I want to go.
Okay.
But here, he was not there. So obviously, I have to do everything by myself only. So after coming here, I joined PrepRite.
Okay.
And then as sir is a very good motivator, obviously. And here I made many more friends. This is how I adapted.
So
here.
Basically, you got out of your comfort zone, but making friends, because you talked about making friends. How important was it to make friends when you moved to a new environment?
Sir, obviously, because people here know better, like Kolkata.
Right.
I don't know. So who lives here, they will know better.
Right. I believe networking is one of the most important aspects, right? Once you are moving to a new place, definitely you will face challenges. That's always there. But if you try to connect with people, make friends, I believe most of them would be happy to help you.
Yes, sir. People here are very helpful. I remember for every time, like, I don't remember roads and all that. I am very...
Right. So, for every small thing, you can ask
sir.
For help.
Yes, sir.
Right. So, now we'll move to the academic part of it. Right. I know that you started your intermediate classes with us around February 2020, right? Your results were out in January 2020 and your classes got started in February 2020. You did around a month of classes and then there was a lockdown and everything got haywired.
Yes,
right? But still you kept on your motivation, your tempo, and you kept on preparing well. So how was the COVID related preparation journey?
So after completing my CA foundation, I joined your classes in Kolkata that were all live classes.
Right.
And then after doing it for like in Feb as sir told, for 1 month, and from 15th March I think lockdown was declared that it will go. So I moved to Durgapur and then there everything went online. And that is that. Initially, it took very. It took time to adapt everything, because in live classes, kya hota hai, sir, sir aate hain, to we see sir, and then we can actually study and focus.
Right. So
but
you are
home,
in a tempo. Like you have to attend the classes, you have to study.
Sir.
There are tests, etc. And since there are live interaction, it's a different environment. But suddenly, when somebody is put to an offline sort of a, online sort of a scenario where you are on its own, right? How much important is discipline to do these classes?
Discipline is very important. We say like discipline and determination are the key factors which guide you towards achieving your goals. So at first, I used to make a study plan for myself. Like initially though, I can't study for longer hours and I can't nobody is actually used to this online classes.
Right. So sitting with your laptop for hours and hours and then
keep on
studying. I believe it would have been difficult for everyone. But then what was important is that she kept her tempo on and cleared intermediate at the very first attempt. Right. So we would like to know about your preparation strategy for CA intermediate. We'll break it into two parts. First, when you do your classes and when you prepare for first 6-7 months, then your revision pattern, right? Please talk about that.
Yes, so first during the classes, as it is suggested by every teachers, every mentor, that we should complete the task whichever we are doing in the class on the same day, on the same day. Also, I used to do that after completing like 2 to 3 online classes. I used to revise that on the same day.
Right. So this is what I keep saying to every student, every batch, every single person who pursues either CA, CS or CMA course or maybe anything in this world. Consistency is the key. And it makes a lot of difference if you do your revisions continuously. Whenever you attend a class, please revise that portion on the very same day. That is the key mantra to success. Most of the students who are able to do that clear in the very first attempt.
Yes, sir. And after like completing classes, only 2 months, I guess, was left.
For revision, right.
Yes, before exam. So in that revision phase, I used to like break my subject, like 2 to 3 subject per day. I didn't took like 4-5 subjects.
So
one practical, it was one theory. I basically started with accounts and law. And then for we have to study for 12 to 14 hours a day. That is mandatory.
Key things which we note here is that first you have to have a revision plan in place. Right? You need to determine that how much time you have to devote per subject and you have to do a back calculation from the date of the exam. And then you have to decide upon the mix of subjects, which subjects you want to do. And most importantly, don't avoid the theory subjects because at the end of it, you will have to clear all of them.
Yes, so after like making this, I used to like do accounts for like 9 to 10 hours, and then after that for 4 to 5 hours that were left, I used to do theory. Like simultaneously I used to do this because studying one subject is very monotonous for
us. Right, so basically you need to devote hours of studies, maybe 12 to 14 hours a day. Okay. So in terms of were 2 months actually sufficient for the preparation? Kya aap sara preparation 2 mahine mein kar paaye the jo aapne plan kiya tha?
Jaise ki bola tha ki we have to study after the class every day. So wo bahut helpful tha, to ek revision to aapka waise hi ho jata hai.
Right. So before the 2 months of the exam, actually one revision was done and you were prepared. Abhi second third revision ki bari aa rahi thi in those 2 months. So those 2 months were sufficient enough, you're saying?
Yes, sir. So for the first month, जैसे combination of practical and theory helped me a lot.
Okay.
So after that, I used to like revise accounts law, then tax and cost. So ऐसे हो गया. And then in the last month, मैंने backward start किया था. Like accounts के लिए last में मैंने 4 to 5 days I allotted.
Okay.
And rest all the subject I covered backward. Like second group भी था. So we have to focus on that also.
So most common question which I get from students is कि sir क्या पहला फर्स्ट ग्रुप को पहले हम रिवाइज कर ले फिर सेकंड ग्रुप रिवाइज करे या दोनों ग्रुप का रिवीजन सब्जेक्ट वाइज साइमल्टेनियसली डाले. व्हाट डू यू थिंक, व्हाट इज अ बेटर अप्रोच?
आई थिंक कि पहले फर्स्ट ग्रुप करना चाहिए एंड देन वी शुड स्टार्ट विद सेकंड ग्रुप ड्यूरिंग रिविजन. और जो लास्ट मंथ जो बचा रहता है उसके लिए फिर जैसे फर्स्ट सेकंड ग्रुप हमने रिसेंटली रिवाइज किया है.
Okay.
तो पहले फिर सेकंड ग्रुप मैंने किया और फिर देन आई केम टू फर्स्ट.
राइट. सो व्हाट शी इज ट्राइंग टू से इज के अगर आप साथ साथ पढ़ते हो तो ग्रुप वन के क्लासेस पहले खत्म हो जाते हैं तो आपने वो रिवाइज कर लिया है, फिर ग्रुप टू के क्लासेस शुरू होते हैं तो ग्रुप टू का भी आप रिवाइज करते जाते हो, तो ग्रुप वन को थोड़ा समय हो जाता है रिवाइज किए हुए. तो पहले ग्रुप वन को सिक्योर कर लो, पहले ग्रुप वन के सारे सब्जेक्ट्स आप रिवाइज कर लो, उसके बाद आप ग्रुप टू के सब्जेक्ट्स रिवाइज करो. सो नाउ अल्टीमेटली द रिजल्ट इज देयर. कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस टू यू दैट आपने दोनों ग्रुप इंटरमीडिएट के एक साथ क्लियर कर लिए फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट में. सो नाउ व्हाट आर योर फ्यूचर प्लान्स? अभी यहाँ से आप क्या एस्पायर कर रहे हो?
सर रिसेंटली आई एम लुकिंग फॉर आर्टिकलशिप.
ओके.
ऑब्वियसली विद गुड एक्सपोजर इन एवरी थिंग. सो एंड आफ्टर कम्प्लीटिंग सी ए ऑब्वियसली एवरी वन वॉन्ट टू स्टैंड ऑन देयर ओन फीट.
राइट.
सो आफ्टर दैट आई वॉन्ट टू एक्चुअली ज्वाइन कॉर्पोरेट वर्ल्ड. दैट फैसिनेट्स मी अ लॉट.
ओके. सो एवरीबडी एज वी से द बिग कॉर्पोरेट ड्रीम. राइट. सो आर्टिकलशिप बहुत जरूरी होती है बिकॉज अगर हम हमारे एक्सपीरियंस से शेयर करें ना, बिकॉज वॉट यू स्टडी इज थ्योरेटिकल. जब आप आर्टिकलशिप करते हो तब आप प्रैक्टिकल वर्ल्ड से कनेक्ट होते हो, उसको आपको अप्लाई करने का अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलता है. दो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट चीजें होती है. एक आप पीपल मैनेजमेंट स्किल्स सीखते हो जहां पे आपको टीम मैनेज करना, टीम प्लेयर बन के रहना, कभी इंचार्ज की ड्यूटी करना, कोई डिफिकल्ट क्लाइंट को हैंडल करना, अपने बॉस को हैंडल करना, तो एक सॉफ्ट स्किल्स आपके डेवलप हो जाते हैं. साथ ही साथ जब आप काम करते हो तो आपके टेक्निकल एरियाज भी डेवलप होते हैं. और 3 साल के बाद आप एक पॉलिश होकर जब सीए बनते हो एक सीजन प्रोफेशनल बनते हो. और इफ यू हैव डन लेट्स से प्रॉपर आर्टिकलशिप तो आपके लिए काफी अच्छी अपॉर्चुनिटीज भी क्रिएट होती है इन दी कॉर्पोरेट वर्ल्ड. बिकॉज अगर आप रियल लाइफ इंटरव्यू फेस करते हो ना तो जो इंटरव्यूअर है उसको क्वेश्चंस के द्वारा पता चल जाता है कि आप ऐसे ही बोल रहे हो कि आपने एक्चुअल में काम किया है कि नहीं. सो ग्रेट. आई बिलीव कि आपकी जो जर्नी आपने बताई वो बहुत लोगों को इंस्पायर करेगी जो लेट्स से छोटे शहरों में या छोटे टाउन्स में रहते हैं, कि वो अपने शेल से बाहर आए और अपने ड्रीम्स को अचीव करने की कोशिश करे. एंड जो आपने प्रिपरेशन मेथड बताया आई बिलीव इट विल हेल्प अ लॉट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स. मैं अगर इसकी समरी बोलूँ ना तो यार क्लासेस के साथ साथ आप पढ़ते रहो. राइट. एंड बाद में रिविजन को ठीक तरह से प्लान करो. या व्हाट एल्स डू यू वांट टू से?
सर जैसे कि आपने सॉफ्ट स्किल मेंशन किया था.
राइट.
इन दिस लाइक पढ़ते तो सब है. एवरीबडी नोज कि एक ना एक दिन दे विल क्रैक देयर एग्जाम्स.
डेफिनेटली.
बट सॉफ्ट स्किल्स, स्पीकिंग स्किल्स, देन कम्युनिकेशन, इंटरपर्सनल स्किल्स, दे आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन दिस. मेरा तो आई वॉज अ इंट्रोवर्ट.
ओके.
बट नाउ आफ्टर कमिंग टू कोलकाता, इंटरेक्टिंग विद पीपल, आई यूज टू लाइक लिटरली व्हेन आई एम सिटिंग इन अ मेट्रो ऑल्सो आई यूज टू टॉक विद अ पर्सन सिटिंग बिसाइड मी.
दैट्स अ ग्रेट एबिलिटी. बिकॉज देखो, नोइंग योर वर्क इज वन पार्ट ऑफ इट, बट गेटिंग योर वर्क डन इज अनदर पार्ट ऑफ इट. और वो आपके इंटरपर्सनल स्किल्स, जो सॉफ्ट स्किल्स होते हैं, उसी से आता है. राइट. हैविंग द एबिलिटी टू मेक फ्रेंड्स, टू कनेक्ट विद पीपल इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग. राइट. सो आई विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट इन योर जर्नी अहेड. आई बिलीव आप जल्दी से सीए बन जाओ और सीए बनने के बाद हम लोग वापस एक इंटरव्यू करें और लोगों को गाइड और मोटिवेट कर पाए.
हियर
डेफिनेटली
आई वॉन्ट टू कोट सम लाइन्स लाइक, इफ यू डोंट सेक्रीफाइस फॉर वॉट यू वॉन्ट बिकम्स अ सेक्रीफाइस. सो वी हैव टू पुश आवरसेल्व्स.
Great. So with this note, with this motivational quote, we'll end this interview. And अगर आप हमसे कनेक्ट करना चाहते हो, आपको किसी भी तरह की गाइडेंस चाहिए, मे बी आप किसी छोटी जगह से किसी दूसरी जगह शिफ्ट होना चाह रहे हो, आप कोर्स के बारे में जानना चाह रहे हो, राइट, किस तरह से आपको अपना करियर प्लान करना चाहिए जानना चाह रहे हो, तो अभी आपको स्क्रीन पर डिस्क्रिप्शन पे एक ईमेल आईडी दिखेगा, उस ईमेल आईडी पे आप ईमेल करो, वी ऑल विल बी वेरी वेरी हैप्पी टू हेल्प यू, बिकॉज वी आर मेकिंग अ ग्रुप जहां पे मैं, मेरे जो स्टूडेंट्स है सारे जो ऑलरेडी क्वालिफाइड हो चुके हैं, अभी इंटरमीडिएट लेवल क्लियर करके फाइनल परस्यू कर रहे हैं, हम सब इस ग्रुप में मिलकर आपको हेल्प करेंगे, विल लेट्स से कन्वर्ट इट इनटू अ ग्रुप, और एक बड़ा नेटवर्क बनाएंगे जिससे हम बहुत लोगों तक पहुंच के उनकी हेल्प कर पाएंगे। ग्रेट, थैंक यू सो मच, होप ये इंटरव्यू आपको इंस्पायर करेगा, एंड थैंक यू अनिकृति फॉर पार्टिसिपेटिंग।
थैंक यू सर।
ग्रेट।